This is Faith in Action, the program that looks at how people put their faith into action in their everyday lives. Faith in Action is a production of Catholic Radio Indy. Now here's today's program.
This is Faith in Action on Catholic Radio. I'm Jim Ganley. Our co-host is Bridget Ayer.
Hello, great to be with you.
And Bridget, I'm going to squeeze in a whole bunch of little announcements here because just got a lot of stuff coming up here. We got a share-a-thon coming up on March 16th and 17th. Can still use a few volunteers to help answer the phone and that sort of thing. So if you can help us, call us. I'm going to give you a number here in just a second. Also, we are going to have a golf outing this year.
Woohoo!
We've had, I think, 10, 11 of them. Last year's, because of the COVID, we actually ended up canceling it. But it's back on this year. So mark your calendar. May 25th at Plum Creek Golf Club. We can use some volunteers there, too. The number to volunteer is 317-870-8400. 317-870-8400. And just want to slip in a little promo here for our brand new program. Most of you know Kent Blanford, our production manager here at Catholic Radio, is host of the Catholic Jukebox program on Saturdays and Sundays. Great program with lots of contemporary Catholic music. Well, Kent stepped up to the plate and he's taken on a big challenge starting on May 23rd on Tuesdays and Thursday.
March 23rd.
What did I say?
May.
Oh, well, no. March 23rd. Thank you. He's going to be hosting a whole noon hour program of various different podcasts from all over the place. Some will be national speakers. Some will be local speakers. Maybe it'll be a homily of a pastor at a local parish here. It's going to be a whole hour of sampling of different podcasts every Tuesday and Thursday beginning March 23rd. So be listening for that. It's going to be quite a program.
Yeah, and today we're going to be talking about, believe it or not, an in-person men's conference. It's the Cincinnati Men's Conference, which is happening March 13th. And joining us is the chairman of the conference and also the founder of the Catholic Speakers Organization, Joe Condit. So, Joe, welcome to Faith in Action. Thanks for being our guest today.
Bridget and Jim, this is an absolute honor to be on with you.
And Joe and I chatted the other day about some of the things that are happening with the Cincinnati Men's Conference, and I think we talked for more than a half an hour, so this should be super easy for us to just crank all this out. Well, how did the Cincinnati Men's Conference get started? It's been rolling for a long time.
It has, actually, and there's a lot of rich history behind it that we want the world to know about, which is why this year we made a national invite to both men and women because of so many cancellations and people starving for spiritual growth. The Cincinnati Men's Conference was the first Catholic men's conference that ever happened in the United States in 1994. It started with five guys-ish in Madeira, Ohio, which is a little suburb right outside of Cincinnati, and these guys had the idea that we need to bring men together specifically for fellowship, right? To get men to find each other, to have men a way to grow in faith together. And the conference was just a hook. It never was about the conference. They just thought, well, let's have a gathering where men will come and hear great messages of faith. And let's get some professional, you know, motivational Catholic speakers in. And that's how it started. And men from all over the world started traveling to Cincinnati, Ohio, to that conference every year. I mean, I think their height, they had 15,000 to 20,000 men.
Wow.
And if you guys remember the major arena, well, maybe you're in Indianapolis, but it used to be called U.S. Bank Arena downtown Cincinnati, and they fill that place.
Yeah.
I remember going there when I was like in sixth grade, I think, when my father took me there, and I got to see Mike Ditka speak. I mean, it was incredible.
Yeah, it was really huge. I actually went to that one time, and we were talking about this too the other day, that I went there as a journalist for the Criterion, the Catholic newspaper in the Archdiocese of Indianapolis, and I was so excited because I was in this. I was like the only woman. No, there were a few there, but I was in a very, very low minority, and I was like, man, I feel so blessed to be able to be here. But I was there as a journalist to cover it, and it was just rocking. And it was in that huge conference center. I don't remember. It was like maybe the mid to late 90s when that happened. So it was awesome.
No, that's exactly. You're right. It was exactly mid to late 90s. And then men that were traveling from all over the country started thinking, well, why don't we have something like this in our community? So the Cincinnati Men's Conference sparked this wave of men starting the same type of format, same type of conference in their communities. And then now you have, in our data at Catholic Speakers Organization, who we work with most, if not all of them, they have definitely called us over the years at least once to book speakers. There's about 200 plus and growing. So you could argue, without a doubt, that the Cincinnati Men's Conference was the one that sparked this wave of what we know today as men's and women's conferences, which is amazing because of the Cincinnati Men's Conference and what those guys thought of, it really started to create this platform that has now evangelized millions of people, without a doubt, since 1994. And so we're really proud about that. We're proud that, you know, in Cincinnati, Ohio, that was where it all began. Just like in baseball, the Cincinnati Reds were the first baseball team. You know, you can't argue that either. So
right. There's
a lot of great people in our community there. So, you know, the men got old. One of them, which is my mentor and an incredible guy, he actually wrote a book about how to evangelize and create a fellowship group. His name is Declan O'Sullivan. He was one of the original founders. He lives in Cincinnati, Ohio. I believe he's in his upper 80s now. They just got to a point where the conference became such a burden financially.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, as you're getting older and retiring, there's only so much energy you got, you know, and it's the family and grandkids. So the conference unfortunately died in 2011. And then, you know, as Catholic speakers grew and the more connections we made, which today, you know, we're the largest Catholic speaking focused network on Catholics, in the world, you know, it's pretty wild. By the grace of God, you know, helping all these speakers get out and tell their message, we decided to pick up the baton and revive the Cincinnati Catholic Men's Conference in 2018. And since then, we've just been blowing and going, and we it's our goal and mission to never let it die again because of such rich history of what we just talked about. You know, how can you let the godfather of them all go away?
You know, with men's conferences and women's conferences too, but with men, there's kind of a tendency, you know, you don't go to work and talk about your faith every day. You don't go, you know, out to dinner and talk about your faith every day. And so you kind of keep it to yourself, keep it inside and think, okay, well, this is what I believe. I don't know what everybody else believes. But when you get to a men's conference, it's reassuring that, hey, there's thousands of people here and they all believe the same as I do. I'm not crazy. I'm not the only one that believes this. And that's really reassuring. And I think that's a really, really important part of any of the conferences.
Absolutely, Jim. I mean, you know, I don't know if you've seen any of my background, but, you know, this is a passion project for me, and I'm involved in a lot of secular businesses. Well, a lot means it's relative. I mean, several different ones. And I made it a mission, me personally, to make sure that people know where I stand. I mean, now more than ever, the spiritual battle is raging so rapidly that it's important for men to, you know, go out and give their faith however they can in the world today.
We're talking with Joe Condit. He is the chairman of the conference, the Catholic Cincinnati Men's Conference, and which is coming up March 13th. And he's also the founder of the Catholic Speakers Organization. I want to talk a little bit about the theme, and it's really interesting when I was reflecting on the theme that we talked about, that you've had some personal adversity. But the theme is, tell us what the theme is, and then let's talk about some of the personal adversity that you've actually had with being censored, ironically. Go ahead and tell us about the theme.
Yeah, well, the theme is timely. We chose it on purpose with COVID, obviously. The theme is, what do I do in the face of adversity? And we've got three speakers, Father Mike Schmitz, arguably one of the most popular preachers, you know, priest going right now with his podcast being number one on iTunes, up there with Joe Rogan, which is, by the grace of God, just unbelievable.
Yeah, that's pretty amazing.
Dr. Ray Grendy, who, as everyone knows, the acclaimed radio host, psychologist, he's an absolute riot. I mean, I'd put him up there with, when he gets on, like any comedian, you know.
No doubt.
Any major comedian. And then Tony Mott, who a lot of folks may or may not know of, but in the Cincinnati area, he's a big, big name. He's a businessman. He's a Catholic philanthropist. He's known for JTM, the food group in the secular world, but he's the one that founded Rural Woods, which is a Catholic Theology of the Abadi mission organization, nonprofit. It does incredible work. So with this theme, we're hoping to help men and women, because they're both invited this year virtually, to get just spiritually fed on how do I overcome these challenges that everyone's dealing with because of COVID. You know, financially, people have been crushed. It's caused a lot of problems. Suicides have gone through the roof, which is amazing because we do have one of the best psychologists in Dr. Ray there to talk about many issues. It's just a great time, more than ever, for people to come together and, you know, in person and mostly virtually, but we will have people there, and I'd love to talk about that in-person struggle we had to go through. But it's just an incredible time for people to come together over such a great topic, and we're excited to bring that spiritual benefit to as many people as we possibly can.
Now, Joe, you mentioned some huge venues where this event has taken place in the past. This year is different, of course, because of COVID. Where is it going to be taking place this year?
The Cincinnati Men's Conference will be on March 13th at St. Ignatius Loyola Parish in Cincinnati. God bless Father Earl Fernandez. I talked to him and I said, Father, we need to do this, you know. And he was, you know, people are very cautious of putting on events this, you know, obviously this year and last year. And Father, after hearing me give him my pitch that now is when people need this conference, not when things are great, he thought to himself, he said, you know what, Joe, you have my blessing. Let's do this. You know, so God bless him for having the foresight. I think we're really going to make some waves with this in a great way.
Now, I'd asked you, that church seats like, what, 1,300? But how many people can you have there on site with regard to COVID? I'm not sure how Ohio's been in relationship to Indiana, and it's been different in different parts of Indiana, like Marion County, which is where Indianapolis is, has been more restricted than maybe outside the, you know, in the donut counties, we call them here. What's it been like there in that area in Cincinnati with regard to how many people you can have in a facility?
Yeah, well, Ohio's really been, you know, they've been strict. So the state of Ohio has been strict, and then, you know, you have the cities that pick up, and then it comes down to the folks. But St. Ignatius Loyola normally holds around 1,000 to 1,300 packed, right, standing room only. We are limited, and I need to stress this to anyone listening, we are definitely complying with all COVID-19 regulations. We're going to make it a safe environment. We're limited to only 225. So max out with workers, everybody included, will be around 250. Speakers, everybody including that building, around 250. But we were limited, you know, to nowhere near what the capacity is. I mean, less than one-fourth, I guess, if my math served me correctly. But, yeah, it's just the times we're in. But we got to do everything we can to get men together and women together to be spiritually fed in a time that's so bizarre.
It is.
You know, where you're told not to go to church, don't go out and see your folks, don't. It's just a weird time to be living, and this is when people need this more than ever, you know.
Well, we're going to take a break, and when we come back, I want to talk a little bit about the censorship that you personally faced and how you're overcoming that adversity. So stay tuned for more Faith in Action.
You're listening to Catholic Radio Indy, converting the culture to Christ through radio, featuring 100% Catholic programming 24/7. Do your friends a favor. Tell them about Catholic Radio Indy. You know us as Catholic Radio Indy, but we're so much more than just radio. We're a voice for the church that's seldom heard in our chaotic world. We're confirmation for the strong of faith and encouragement and answers for those in doubt. We're there to rejoice with your triumphs and to be a voice of consolation through the dark times. We're a voice for vocations and proudly pro-life. We are Catholic Radio Indy and CatholicRadioIndy.org.
You can hear the Holy Mass every day at 8 a.m. right here on Catholic Radio Indy.
Welcome back to Faith in Action. I'm Bridget Ayer. Jim Ganley and I are in the studio, and we're talking with our guest, Joe Condit. He is the chairman of the Cincinnati Men's Conference, which is coming up March 13th, and he's also the founder of the Catholic Speakers Organization, which is kind of a funnel for Catholic speakers, and I guess you said it was...
And we got to talk about that, because he's got some pretty impressive... speakers in the lineup of people, a lot of names that people would recognize, and somebody may be thinking for a parish event might be thinking, yeah, but how would we ever get that particular person? Well, we'll talk about that in a few minutes.
Well, tell us now this venue is also open for women, so that's kind of a cool thing, and it's virtual as well, because you guys are you all full now for your in-person aspect? Is that part sold out?
We are, by the grace of God. Before we even started promoting it, just through friends and word of mouth, it filled up. But to be clear, on the on-site campus, it's men only.
Okay.
But what we realized is that women can benefit from this as well. You know, be having a headliner like Father Mike Schmitz and a family man like Dr. Ray Guarendi and Tony Moss, we decided that with all the events that are canceling all over the country, because we see them all canceling through Catholic Speakers Organization, where we are... we are struggling just to get our speakers out to preach the Word of God. We have decided to open it up to men and women to virtually enjoy together. So we're making a national invite, CincinnatiMen'sConference.com. You can register. It's completely free. The event's free. And men and women can get on there and enjoy, make it a date morning. It's only a half day, and hang out and see some real inspiration.
And you were talking, we talked again the other day when we were chatting, you were saying, you know, instead of having a Netflix date, you know, you can have a Catholic Men's Conference date, right?
Absolutely. No, I'm glad you brought that up, Bridget. I mean, we're competing with Netflix, you know, and people are looking at what different things to look at, you know, on live stream and watch. And we have to bring the game when it comes to the spiritual realm. And I think we have with Father Mike Schmitz. I mean, mm-hmm. This guy's got, I can't stress it enough, a priest has a number one podcast in the United States of America. This guy is special. And I've been telling all my friends and, you know, in the community, people are going to talk about this forever, where they got to see Father Mike in such an intimate setting, you know, and in the west side of Cincinnati, where I believe when things get back to normal, that poor guy, he's probably going to be out preaching same crowds as Father John Carapi. That's just my personal opinion, because he's so effective and he's a man of God. He's got one mission, spread the word of God and be a priest. And you know, now that I know him, it's more clear than ever that this guy is hopefully going to be rise to be a real great leader of the church.
Now, online, individuals will be able to participate and hear all of the different speakers and things like that. Are you encouraging parishes around the country or outside of the Cincinnati area to maybe have a little get together, maybe a, you know,
watch
a 10
party.
Or 20, yeah, a watch party, you know,
a
10 or a 15, 20 person, whatever their parish can accommodate, all get together and watch it. Are you encouraging that too, or are you anticipating more of just individuals watching it?
No, we are. We're asking people to get out there and watch it. We have watch parties. We're actually this week starting to reach out to every women's conference and men's conference we've booked speakers for, and in making the national invite, saying Father Mike Schmitz wants you to join in. So we're hoping that all of the conferences all over the country send an email out to their folks and say, hey, have a watch party at your house or a men's group or women's group. Have coordinate at your parish and get together and see this. You know, experience the first conference of them all. That's what we're trying to get across. And at the same time, hear a wonderful topic that couldn't be more timely, you know, to overcome adversity from some of the best speakers in the Catholic realm that are going, you know. So it's a combination of a lot of great things that we're, you know, obviously we're really excited about.
Well, I was really surprised when you told me that you personally had been censored. Tell us quickly about that story and how really important is tying into having grassroots communications to kind of get around that if that happens to you.
That censoring is almost a badge of honor these days.
Yeah.
I guess that's right, Jim. That's a great way to put it. I mean, yeah, we are definitely being censored by big tech. And when I say big tech, just think, you know who we're talking about. There's like four or five of them.
Mm-hmm.
When COVID hit, Catholic Speakers Organization was identified as one of the largest influencers in the country because of the nature of the work we do. We promote all the people that have all the lists of millions and hundreds of thousands of folks, right? Mm-hmm. So we start trying to promote all the things we're doing, and we will get ads that we run that come back to us after a month of running it where we think it's running, and it'll say, oh, sorry, zero impressions, zero reach, $0. You know, what do we do? We just lost a month. What are we going to do at that point? When we post things on Facebook prior to the, and I'll tell you when it happened, is when we came out with this motivational video series called Inspire Word, and it was around the election, and I was out telling people, you only got one choice as a Catholic. There's only one pro-life candidate. You know, that's it. And once that started happening, and all the faith-based leaders I had on InspireWord.com, you can see all the videos. I mean, everything started changing. Our email provider that we were using completely, all of our emails started going to spam. You know, I know it because I tested it personally. Our posts on the other platforms, we'd get like 10 views. The average person, you know, one of these platforms, we all know who, has about 500 friends. You're telling me when we have a reach of hundreds of thousands of people, one post gets only a couple hundred likes or views? It was obvious to us we started being targeted because of our forwardness and our black and whiteness of where we stood politically, but religiously.
Mm-hmm. Have you
so it was. It's real. It's real. People, if Catholics don't... Go ahead, Jim.
Have you made any changes in platforms? I mean, there's some new platforms that I think didn't exist a year or so ago, and sometimes people that are getting kicked off or throttled on some of the popular ones are going to other ones. Have you made any changes in that regard yet?
Yeah, we're shifting over to a lot of the alternative ones, and we're hoping that they're going to take, but the majority of the world, you know, is still on these big ones, and preaching to the choir has been something that I've been trying to, you know, we try and keep that strong, but our biggest mission as Catholic Speakers Organization is to reach those that, you know, aren't going to show up. Like this men's conference, the EWTN crowd, as I call them, incredible, faithful folks, they're going to show up every time.
Mm-hmm.
I want to reach people that just that need it, that aren't going to church, that don't put their faith as a priority, and, you know, you still got to stay in their faith. So, the censorship is real. And, you know, my buddy over at Catholic Online, Michael Galloway, we trade war stories on this all the time. And when you reach a certain point of people that you're influencing, and they know it because they have all your data,
mm-hmm.
you start getting censored.
Mm-hmm. Especially if you're saying things that are kind of outside the cultural norms, then Catholics certainly are countercultural at this point in time, you know. So, yeah, I'm glad you shared that. And obviously that plays right into the theme of, you know, what do I do when facing adversity? Do you have any tips or anything that the speakers are going to bring forth? Do you have any tips on that or any insights on what they're going to share, each of the speakers, what their specific topics are?
Sure. Well, Father, I've asked all three speakers to share two or three stories that they've never talked about before. So that's going to be something completely unique to the conference, which they've all agreed. They're going to add two or three stories of their own personal adversity to their life, which I can't wait. I mean, how exciting is that?
That's
right?
Going to be awesome.
So that's going to be completely unprecedented and unique to the conference there. So, you know, getting these guys to come on and talk about what we're all experiencing, I hope it will hopefully spiritually help others, you know, in a time where folks are just, they don't know what to do. You know, me personally, our staff, you know, first is prayer. You know, you gotta trust in God and just keep trying to do His will. And that's all you can do. I tell you, I hear all the time when people call the organization, God wants this to happen. God, you know, I'm very hesitant to say what I think what God wants.
Mm-hmm.
But I do know in your Catholic faith, you try and stay in sanctifying grace the best you can, and you pray to do His will. You can't go wrong.
Amen. Well, how can people... spread the word, I guess. I like the idea of I could see the wife and women listening, you know, can say, hey, sign up and get your husband to watch it if maybe they're not even inclined, or maybe even invite some friends over, you know, wear your mask if you need to do that. But Indiana's been, I think, pretty open. We haven't been super strict here, and our numbers, a lot of our area is in the blue, so we're not, you know, our numbers are going down. We just looked at the map yesterday or the other day. So, but yeah, how can people spread the word? We've got a couple minutes left, so I'll let you chat about that.
Post it on social media. Go to our website at CincinnatiMensConference.com. Again, that's CincinnatiMensConference.com to get Father Mike's invitation video. Just share that. Go to Father Mike's invitation video on the website, copy the link, post it on your Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, whatever. Social media, through all of us, on a grassroots effort, is what's going to help us get the word out since we're being censored. And I can't thank you enough for asking and also having me on this radio show, because that's going to help us get the word out. And we're after women. It's amazing how many women are signing up for a men's conference. But it's my Trojan horse, my staff. We were talking, women are going to be the ones that motivate their men to get on and watch this thing. And God bless them, you know. There's so much truth behind every man. There's a great woman. And we have more women right now, I think, signing up for the men's conference. So the men need to get their act together. But, you know, we're glad it's happening, because everybody's going to share in this. It's a family event. You couldn't spend more time with have a time to spend with each other better than this cause.
And the online virtual portion of it is free?
Absolutely. Everything's free. We're flipping the bill at Catholic Speakers Organization.
Wow.
You know, in a time where we made $0 in 2020. We're negative. So it's, you know, if we think this is, and this is just me personally, this is a spiritual war. This isn't about a virus. This is a spiritual war. And until good men wake up and realize that, none of this is ever going to make sense.
And I think, if anything, 2020 has really revealed a lot of things that maybe we're not, we weren't aware of, maybe that were there the whole time. Just maybe the division in our country, the lack of spirituality that people have in their lives, and just a lot of, you know, a lot of healing that's needed, and a lot more evangelization that we really need to be stepping up and doing our part. Joe, what are you looking forward to most in terms of the conference yourself?
The one person gets converted to go back to church or make their faith a priority. I mean, that's our mission, is to reach that one person, to help as many people as possible, but to reach people that actually need this. Again, we're trying to go up beyond the inside box of Catholics. We're trying to reach as many people as possible, which is why this interview is so important, because you never know who's going to hear it, who might make time for it, what woman's going to motivate her man to go to it, hint, hint, you know, share it and watch together virtually. That's what it's all about, is sharing the Word of God with people that, whether they realize it or not, in times like this especially, they need it more than ever.
So, Joe, give us the date and the website again so that people can mark their calendar and get signed up.
Yes, please mark March 13th. It's going to start at about 6:30 a.m. and go to 12 noon. It's CincinnatiMen'sConference.com to get all the details. The entire conference is free. We did that so nobody would be scared or have to decide, can I afford this, because I haven't worked regularly in the last year. CincinnatiMen'sConference.com. In person is already filled, so that's not even an issue, but it's at St. Ignatius Loyola Parish in Cincinnati. Again, God bless and thank Father Earl Fernandez for his support of this, and we cannot wait. Our goal is to get 10,000 virtual viewers. Again, women, I need you to help me out with that. The men are last minute. We're all of us guys are last minute, and we're just so excited to see what Father Mike, Dr. Ray Guarendi, and Tony Moss have in store for all of us.
That's awesome. Well, Joe Condit has been our guest today. He is the chairman of the Cincinnati Men's Conference and the founder of the Catholic Speakers Organization. Thanks so much for being our guest today for Faith in Action.
This has been a real honor. Thank you both. God bless you, too.
God bless you, Joe.
You have been listening to Faith in Action, the program that looks at how people put their faith into action in their everyday lives. Faith in Action is a presentation of Catholic Radio Indy. You can hear this episode of Faith in Action again, or any past episode, at CatholicRadioIndy.org. If you have a suggestion for a guest or topic for a future program, please call us at 317-870-8400 or email Jim at CatholicRadioIndy.org.